In Storyboard Pro, these sections of the software, so the thumbnail view, for example, the stage view, they're known as views. So there are a few different ways to add views. One of them is by going to the top menu and selecting Windows, and then clicking on any of these views that you see here. So let's select the top view, and we can see that it's opened up here by the name on this tab. Another way that you can open another view is by clicking on the plus sign on the corner of any of the pre-existing areas designated for views. So here for the timeline as well. So let's click on this plus button and select function editor. So now we can see the function editor view here. And if you decide you just like to close any of these views, you need only to click on the little X in the corner. In addition to opening and closing views, you can also swap their location in the software. So for example, here we have the color portion of the tool properties view. So I can grab this tab and pull it out. And essentially there are three things I can do with this tab. I could either drop it in order to create a floating window. So now this color portion of the tool properties view is a floating window. Or I can grab the tab again, so not the title bar of this window, but this tab, the gray color tab of the view, and I can drag around to parts of the software until I see this turquoise highlight appear, which allows me to drop and anchor the view into a section of the software. Or I can grab this tab and I can hover it over other tabs so that it now becomes one of the tabbed views in an already docked part of the software. So let's put that back where it was before. In addition to this, you can also collapse and expand different views. So for example, there's a double arrows here between these two sections of the software. We see these again here between the stage view and the timeline, and here between the thumbnail view and the timeline. So if we click on one of these buttons, we can essentially hide a view. So I just hid the timeline view or collapsed it. And if I click on the up arrow, I can bring it back again. So that was to expand the color view. And you can do the opposite. You can collapse the tool properties view and all the other tabs that are listed up here. And after having moved around a bunch of views, you might find that it looks a little bit funny and you're no longer comfortable with the new placement or position of where you drag and dropped all the views. So what you can do is go to the top menu and select Windows, Restore Default Workspace. And in fact, the last time I launched Storyboard Pro, I added the timeline view, which is why it disappeared when I restored the default workspace. And that also lets you know that if you add or change views, so maybe let's add the timeline back again. The next time you open your project, this timeline will still be here because the software automatically saves your current workspace.